कॉम्बी जूट फाइबर. बेसिकली जूट इज अ टाइप ऑफ नेचुरल फाइबर. बेसिकली इट इज ऑब्टेन्ड फ्रॉम प्लांट्स. सो वी कैन से दैट जूट इज एक्चुअली अ प्लांट फाइबर. एंड एक्चुअली फ्रॉम द प्लांट इट इज ऑब्टेन्ड फ्रॉम द स्टेम ऑफ दैट प्लांट. एंड द जूट प्लांट इज बेसिकली नोन एज द पैटसन. सो वी कैन से दैट जूट इज ऑब्टेन्ड फ्रॉम द स्टेम्स ऑफ द पैटसन प्लांट. नाउ देर आर बेसिकली सम कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ द जूट प्लांट. द फर्स्ट वन ऑफ देम is that it has a shiny surface, and because it has a shiny surface, so sometimes it is also referred to as the golden fiber because of its shine and because of its luster. Also, the next property is that it is 100% biodegradable. That means it is decomposed easily into the soil and it will not cause any harm to the environment. It will not pollute the environment also. So it is 100% biodegradable. Moreover, it is durable also. The various jute bags, gunny bags, or even sacks, they are all made up of jute, and these are very durable. You can use it for a very long period of time. You can say even for years. So these were some of the categories or some of the characteristics of the jute plant. Let us consider those processes which are used to obtain the jute fiber, how the jute fiber develops. So the first step for the formation of jute fiber is that basically the seeds of the jute fiber or the jute plant are sown in the beginning of the rainy season. That means they are sown in the month of March, April. As they are sown in the beginning of the rainy season, so it is sometimes referred to as the rainy crop or the rainy season crop, because it is sown in the beginning of the rainy season. When the seeds are sown, they become mature and they reach to a certain height. The height of the jute plant ranges from 6 feet to 12 feet. That means it is actually a very huge plant. So when it has reached to a certain height, that is around 6 feet to even 12 feet, and it starts to flower, that means it begins to flower. So the colors of the flower of this plant are yellow. So we can say that the jute plant bears yellow color flowers. Now when this plant is in the flowering stage, it is bearing some flowers, it is cut down. That means the jute plant are cut in the flowering stage, not in the mature stage and not when it is too young. Because when it is too young, the jute has not been developed, so we cannot cut it. But when it is in the mature stage, we will not cut the jute plant because it has now become very strong. And it is very difficult to remove the jute fiber from that plant. So we harvest this plant in the flowering stage or in the flowering stage. It is upon you how you pronounce. So in the flowering stage we harvest this plant. So when we have harvested this plant in the flowering stage, in the flowering stage, we make bundles. So we make bundles of this fiber and we dip these bundles into a stagnant water. Now these bundles are dipped in stagnant water, basically a pond, and when they are dipped in pond for about a week or for about few days, the fibers start to separate out. They become very loose and they start to separate out. Now this process of the fibers to separate out from the bundles, when they are dipped into water for a very long period of time, this is known as retting of jute. Now this is known as retting of jute. So the fibers are now separated out. The human being or the farmer who is doing the farming of the silk or farming of the jute will collect these fibers and then he will keep them to dry in the sun. So the next step is they are being dried in the sun. Now when they are dried into the sun, again we form the bundles and we send these bundles to the mill. And in the mill, various types of machines are there which produce the fabrics. Some may produce the jute jewelry, some may produce jute bags, shopping bags, gunny bags, ropes, etc. So all these are made up of jute. So the next property of jute, we can say that it is used to make shopping bags, because as we know it is biodegradable, so it is a better alternative in the case of plastics. So we should always prefer jute bags whenever we are going to shopping. This will help in helping in reducing the pollution from the environment. This was the concept of jute fiber. We have discussed how the jute fiber is obtained from the plant as a rainy season crop, and then it has attained a certain height. Basically, it is a huge crop. So during the flowering stage, we can harvest that plant and we can do the retting. Then finally, we can send the bundles in the mill, from where we can get different types of materials like ropes, bags, etc. This was the concept of jute fiber.